Nicholas and Alexandra is an historical epic from the early 70s, produced by Sam Spiegel, directed by Franklin Schaffner, fresh off the success of Patton, and based on the biography by Robert Massey about the last days of the Romanov dynasty. I thought it made a good transition into this series, both because of my past and looking forward to the future. As far as the past is concerned, I always had a really deep love of history, wherever that comes from. But until I saw Nicholas and Alexandra, I didn't really think of movie epics so much as realistic representations of history. At most, I was interested in battle scenes and other forms of spectacle. Whereas, of course, Nicholas and Alexandra is very intimate and very focused on character. It was also the first time I was exposed to the fantasy-ecle period. Up until that time, my interest in the past tended to be a little earlier, toward the 19th century. And so that in itself was hugely important in my eventual development in my criticism, in my filmmaking, and other films that I would go to. And finally, it was also the beginning of my interest in Eastern Europe. So it worked very much to expose me to an aspect of history and of culture that I was unfamiliar with. And among the things that it exposed me to were cinematic uses of imagery that were very similar to history painting, which in itself is important because I knew nothing about painting. But when I went to college, I ended up majoring in art history, if for no other reason because of the history. That's to say, finding out that art had a history. And my initial attraction was toward things like these big battle scenes and crowd gatherings and so on. I eventually went elsewhere, but that was my entryway into the discipline that became central to my look at the world and certainly my look at film. Now, on that note, though, I should say that stylistically, there isn't much similarity between Nicholas and Alexandra and any of my mature work. It's definitely in the so-called classical style, which is not my normal mode of operation. However, I would point to a couple of things. One is Freddie Young's cinematography. For those of you who don't know, Freddie Young was most famous at that time, probably for Lawrence of Arabia, Dr. Zhivago, and similar efforts. And so it made sense that he would be the cinematographer on this effort to recreate Russian history. One thing I like about Young's work as a cinematographer is his use of the medium close-up. It's a central aspect of all film expression, but I always really love it when it's done well. And that's one reason why in my work, there's a fair amount of use of medium close-up, such as this video, for example. The other aspect of the production that is important for my eventual development is the production design. Now, at the time I saw the movie, I had never heard the word. And in fact, even though I went on to some fame, such as it is, in academia for talking about production design, it was quite a while before I had any real sense of what it was and how it influenced things. But having said that, Nicholas and Alexandra was instrumental in helping me to formulate at least some aspects of my theories about production design. So one of the things that definitely comes through is the extreme care that is put into particularly the crowd scenes. Everything is very carefully composed. It's very geometric. And that's very much part of the key to production design as a discipline. And the designer on Nicholas and Alexandra, John Box, was famous by then. He had also worked on Dr. Zhivago, among other things. And there are rumors that when George Stevens, who was originally supposed to direct the film, dropped out, that Box was going to take over, but he didn't. It went to Schaffner instead. But in any event, you'll notice if you ever watch the film that in the crowd scenes or even some of the interiors, there's this very careful use of the space and objects in the space to enhance the storytelling and the forward movement of things. Now, what I just described is true of most movies, but I had to discover that in films like Nicholas and Alexandra. So that seemed like a really good place to start this quasi-reminiscence about old films and aspects of my life. So I hope you enjoyed it. And we'll move on from here to perhaps slightly, how should I put this? Less conservative filmmaking.